I need your guidance regarding Siemens dishwasher problems.
F2 is the heater error code, meaning the heating element is either burned out or there's an electrical problem with it.
I'm hiring a repairman for either of those problems.
There's a chance the heater error code is because the control board is acting up.
I'll try to power cycle the unit via the circuit breaker, and if that does not work, I know it needs someone to do something technical.
Error code 07 is related to the NTC sensor, so you need to electrically check it and all its connections.
What is an NTC sensor, aside from another TLA, three-letter acronym?
The NTC is a thermistor that measures the temperature of the water in the dishwasher.
Then I could clean it too, since food residue or detergent gunk could be covering it, interfering with it the way rust can a thermostat inside a hot water heater.
If it runs through the motions but doesn't actually use water, like making motor noises but not getting wet, check the water inlet pipe.
That is not blocked. And before you asked, yes, I paid my water bill.
Unplug it, take the left side panel and top panel off. Next to the pressure chamber should be a blue lever, and you want it to be on the in position.
What if it isn't?
Press it in, reassemble the panels, plug it back in and try to run it. The circulation pump won't run unless that lever is pushed in, running the micro switch.
What is F9?
The fault code is for unexplained heating in the machine, such as when the unit thinks it is heating up during a rinse cycle with cold water.
That's dangerous, if it is overheating.
It could be a sign of an electrical problem, or the control panel could be malfunctioning.
Now we're back to Microsoft's favorite tech support solution, if in doubt, reboot.
F10 is a communication error, usually between the control module and the motor.
That's also a reason why it might not be doing much but filling and emptying.
Fault code 23 is for a leak the machine recognizes, though not all Siemens dishwashers have a pump to pump water out of the pan under it in case it floods.
I do not think mine does. But if I want a leak check, I take the kick panel off and look, though I do suspect a leak.
If the start button flashes but won't start, and there's water in the bottom of the dishwasher, it is either a blocked filter so bad the unit won't run until it is cleaned or dead pump motor.
It runs periodically, just not well. And the dishes never dry out.
If the dryer wasn't working, the fan motor that runs it might be burned out.